He's my dad, who doesn't know where he is or what's going on. But he's a good reminder to all of us what to do and what not to do. He was always so independent and proactive, but the first thing dementia does, it saps away your willpower and the ability to fight back. So it's either now or never. Five, stupid COVID, years ago I did a genetic test with 23andMe and got my suspicion confirmed. I carry APOE4 gene mutation, the strongest risk factor gene for Alzheimer, which my dad suffers from. And that wasn't good news, probably the worst I ever got, so I felt quite terrible back then. But if life taught me anything, is that you should always at least try to jujitsu your weak points into the features. When life hands you a lemon, make a lemonade. I've managed to do it once before with Lyme disease, but could I do it again with something as serious as dementia? And so I dove deep into the latest science, all the podcasts, groups, and medical advice I could find for the possible cures. And one evening, I was driving from work, listening to STEM Talk. It's kind of interesting how the memory works, because I remember exactly where I was taking exit from Mass Pike, Route 90, through 28, when it hit me. There is no silver bullet against dementia, but there is a silver net. There is no single cause, and there is no single solution. But there are four main avenues, or like four legs, which support the healthy brain. And you need all of them to be in place if you don't want to land on your ass. So why am I telling you all this? If you have dementia in your family, or have APOE4 mutation, or extra belly fat, which is a big risk factor, please watch the video till the end and take some mental notes. The brain is just another organ, like a muscle, and to be and feel good, it needs the same things. Number one, protect your brain from the damage. Kinda obvious, right? External and internal. I use HEPA filters and water filters to remove all the potential toxins, minimize junk food and alcohol, and if you're hooked up to the beer like I am, there are some vacuum evaporated beers on the market which are quite amazing. Leg number two, exercise your brain. If you don't use it, you lose it. You have your brain for several main reasons. A. Learning, which you actually do right now, so good job. Make sure to subscribe, select all to keep that learning streak going. And to do it efficiently, you should not be afraid to fail. So, never ever take yourself seriously. B. Moving. Hopefully you do that, but if you can add some complex routines into your life, dancing, drumming, martial arts, even better. When you move, you bring more oxygen and nutrients to your brain. And C, socializing. That's what I call don't be an asshole. Don't forget friends, be part of a community. Try to be good to people around you. Smile, say thank you anytime you can. Thank you for watching, by the way. Number three, rest and recover. Regular sleep is the king. I have an alarm, both to wake up and to go to bed, and the whole greet the sun morning routine to jumpstart the circadian rhythm ahead. I try to minimize the social excitatory exposure in the evening and do like 5 minutes of meditation and 30 seconds of journaling. It's not that much. It's important to keep the bedroom dark and cool, and I have a separate video just about that if you're interested, and you should be good. Leg number four, feed your brain. All steps are important, but this one is usually the most neglected or hard to achieve. Dementia is called type 3 diabetes for a reason, and it was my weakest point as well. Our brain is a very energy demanding organ, and it gets most of that energy from sugar, with a backup plan in the form of fat. There is also lactate, but it's not that important in this story. And the problem arises when you start to develop some insulin resistance. In one picture, it looks like this. Excuse my AI. That poor guy who gets shoved in is blood sugar. The police officers are insulin. They have opened the door, glued for transporter, and are trying to get sugar back to work. The dude on the right is currently laid off and unemployed, diacylglyceride, fat, which you are not using very efficiently anymore because of over-reliance on sugar all the time. And so he goes on strike and blocks the entrance. That actually would physically resist the insulin in insulin resistance. And so the fat is underutilized, the sugar doesn't get in, and the brain starts to quietly starve. And problem is, when your brain cells start to die off, well, it's kinda too late. And as I said, to my surprise, it was the weakest point of mine. I wasn't that overweight or anything, could do a bunch of pull-ups, but when I installed a CGM into myself for the first time to check my blood sugar under the load, I was horrified. Well, that was then. Dropping a bit of extra fat, adding some muscle, a lot of zone to exercise, and disaster averted. That bad APOE4 mutation turned out to be a blessing in disguise. Without it, I would never go on the journey and would be much worse off, because that metabolic syndrome I was slowly sliding into underlines not just dementia, which I'm hopefully now protected against, but also heart disease, cancer. It might be too late for my dad, but hopefully it's not too late for me and you. So regardless if you have the same mutation as I do or not, I highly recommend you watch this video about my CGM experience. It was absolutely instrumental in my recovery. We have so many carbs pushed on us daily, and it's an amazing tool to understand yourself better and to push back. Living is smart, aging is bad. See you there.